Tell me, did you enjoy the festival in context? Did you enjoy this time? So was it a cracker-free Diwali or was it with cracker Diwali?
Mom with cracker.
Mom with cracker.
Mom with cracker.
Okay. Fine.
Ma'am, so, only sparklers. Only sparklers.
Okay. Okay. Fine. So you have to guess where this form of Diwali is celebrated.
Mom, your voice is cracking.
North India or North? About this one. Okay. This picture depicts what celebration? I mean, celebration in which area? The South India or North India? Yes, Manasvi. Okay, and how can you say so, Manasvi?
By the form, like we are decorating the Rangoli and they are
lighting. So, how is it different? Like in South, people don't light diyas. Is that okay? So, when we come to picture A, so it is mostly
North India.
It's North India, okay. And when it comes to sari,
mom, South India.
Yes. So, Manasvi, I think you talk the opposite. Okay, so A picture is North India and B picture is South India. Basically, you decided with their dresses. Okay. Now, can you guess where is Kali Pujan celebrated? In South India. Okay. Any idea? Okay, in which part of West India, I mean, which state specifically? East side, okay. In South. Okay, please, online responses.
Ma'am, I want to say.
Where do you think Kali Pujan takes place?
Ma'am, yes, I think it takes place in eastern side, like Odisha, Assam, this side.
Ma'am, I think it takes in eastern south. Ma'am, eastern side.
Okay. Mainly Kali Pujan. See, now we have been living in one country since many years, or I would say for 13 or 12 years now. Having known our traditions, having known our country, we are still a little dicey. Where is it celebrated? Some people are saying it's in southeast, some people are saying it's in west, maybe in the central part, right? So Kali Pujan basically takes place in area, particularly Kolkata, that we say, West Bengal, Odisha, this side Kali Pujan takes place, and it is called as eastern part of India, right? There people revere, new word for you people, R-E-V-E-R-E, revere. Cheshta, would you mind closing the door? Revere means respect, R-E-V-E-R-E, okay? Or they are devotees of goddess Kali. Revere is to respect, to give respect. And this is not only used with just the god or goddesses. This is also used with people whom common people would really like to give a lot of respect. Like we talk about Bollywood, celebrities like Amitabh Bachchan. So people revere him. If we talk about Rajinikanth, people have got his temple, right? So he is also revered. Similarly, goddess Kali is revered. Okay, there are many devotees of goddess Kali in West Bengal, Kolkata, Orissa side, so eastern part of India, right? And this is being shown as Lakshmi Pujan in West. Okay, now why we are talking about it, I'll give you a clue later on. So here is the first clue for you people. Now it's written, Diwali was celebrated with full vigor everywhere. Okay, Diwali was celebrated. Okay, but I would like to know who celebrated Diwali. We generally see these as a headline. Diwali was celebrated in full spirit. This is a newspaper headline, basically. Diwali was celebrated with full vigor, with full spirit, in full spirit, right? And Diwali was celebrated with full energy. But then who celebrated Diwali? Who celebrated Diwali? Common people. Okay, not only common, I mean everyone, if I talk about. So this is the first, yes, Tejas?
I'm human beings.
Human beings in particular. So when headlines like this appear in the newspapers, where the inanimate objects basically, like Diwali, which is a festive moment or an event, is being given limelight rather than the person who are actually celebrating that event. Such part of grammar is called as voice. Okay. Diwali is actually so limelighted because of the sparkles outside, crackers outside. But then who is doing that has been subsided, has been hidden. Right. So voice talks about the events. Passive voice basically talks about the events. But those who carry out the events are being hidden. Okay, so this is the first hint for you. When you read the newspaper, you will find many headlines which are full of passive voice only. Like, the house was looted. Now, house is in limelight. It is inanimate thing, right? But who looted that is being hidden. It is obvious actually that the thieves will do that. Similarly, here also it is obvious that human beings will celebrate. So something which comes to the limelight first takes the space of passive voice. Now, question for you people, how did you celebrate Diwali? A quick discussion like we did yesterday, okay, in the breakout rooms. Today also we'll do the same. 30 seconds to 1 minute timer will be played. I'll show you how did you celebrate Diwali. But first let me put people in the breakout room. 7 rooms will be allotted. And 2 minutes time, I think, is more than enough. And you need to really be expressive in 2 minutes. The questions are here. You need not to be restricted to the options which are given over here. You can express over and above. By eating sweets, lighting lamps, offering prayers, or all of the above, right? So rooms are open here. Please accept the request. And here, please form the group, you two, okay? You three can be together and you three can be together. Faster do that.
Ma'am, can
so did you dress up the way these people have in the picture? How were you dressed, in formals or ethnic or Western wear?
Ma'am, what's ethnic?
Ethnic that belongs to your culture, basically, which shows your culture spirit.
Ma'am, I wore lehenga choli, which is ethnic.
That's ethnic, of course.
Ma'am, casual.
Okay, so that's a Western wear. Uh-huh. Okay.
Mummy, ma'am.
Okay, everyone celebrated Diwali across India, whether north, south, west, or east. So which group do you think you belong to? Kids, teenagers, adults, or old people?
Teenagers.
Ma'am, okay, teenagers.
Teenagers.
Now, having known that
teenagers.
Diwali is being given limelight, this is just small, challenge for you people. Try to convert this slide in a headline, as I did earlier, like Diwali was celebrated with full vigor everywhere. This was a headline. Okay. So try to convert the entire content of this slide in a headline. I'll give you a few seconds to do that. You can write it in your notebook.
Ma'am, what?
Headline has to be 5 to 6 words long. So if you still want to add, it's your choice. I would not recommend.
Ma'am, what we have to do?
convert this into a headline. And headline means it has to be passive
voice. Ma'am, what to convert?
What, bache?
Ma'am, what we have to convert?
You have to convert this entire slide content into a headline.
Okay.
Except the question which is written here. Done? Those who are online, please give your chat response. Give your chat response. Have you got the phone with you right now? I'm forwarding you the story. Take care. You can write it on the board. Okay, so I was saying that in passive voice, the activator. Okay, now who's the activator who's opening the door? So that is hidden. But what is coming in front is the object, inanimate object. Doors are opened. Okay, so this is called as passive voice. And how are we going to, identify this thing? So I'm going to make this bifurcation for you people. Here I will be writing active voice, which is nothing but the tenses. Okay, and here will be the passive voice. So when I say the Darbans, you know who are Darbans?
Ma'am, the people who are at the door and they open.
Yes, the Darbans opened the doors. Okay, this is just one example. Now the activators here are the Darbans. So when we are talking about big bungalows, big house, we know there is always somebody who has a duty to open and close the door, right? So we would just move them away, because this is already in our memory. Just shoo them away, basically. What comes in the picture is giving importance to the door. Jaise hi aapne wahan kadam rakha, maybe you have entered a fort, say Nimrana Fort, that's a hotel, right? So aapke liye ekdam darwaze khol diye gaye. So you will feel proud, no? The moment we entered, doors were opened. But will you pay attention on the Darbans? No. You will just feel pride on yourself that the moment I stepped in, big doors were opened. But who is operating them behind? They are hidden. So here in passive voice, we give them, in active voice, we give them importance. And in passive voice, we hide them. So how are we going to do it? The doors were opened. Here were we are using. Why we are using were? Because we have mentioned V2 here. Okay. Now, what is the formula? The formula says that Darbans are the subject plus verb form is second plus doors are the object. So this is simple past, right? So the passive, in passive voice, what we will do is we will bring the object in front. Okay. And we will add the helping verbs of past tense. What are helping verbs of the past tense? We will do it was and were. Okay. And then V3. This is common. The magical hand will always come with V3 by subject. So the activator or the magical hand will carry V3 by plus subject always. And in past tense, helping verb is equal to was or were.
Now, what is the answer?
And the
Subject. Activator. Yes. So helping verb is was and were, and I'm specifically talking about active voice in past tense. This is simple past tense. So don't confuse it. Ki har tense mein use ho jayega. No, this is only for simple past tense. Okay, helping verb of simple past. Understood? So when I say Diwali was celebrated, is it active voice or passive voice?
Passive.
And converted into active. Converted into active, write it.
Everyone celebrated the Diwali.
Very good. Everyone celebrated Diwali. Yes, ma'am. Do we have them? Empty? You can use this. Okay, so everyone celebrated Diwali. So we are not giving importance to everyone, but we are giving importance to Diwali, right? I hope you have all written this formula by now.
Ma'am, please write it.
Now we will move to the next page. The mail has been sent on Diwali. The mail has been sent. Do you think it is active voice or passive voice?
Passive.
Ma'am, passive.
Yes. Who can be the magical hand behind it?
Ma'am, postman.
Postman, okay. Very obvious. Or if we are talking about email,
ma'am, the then boss sends the email.
Again, the persons, humans. Yes. So, can we make an active out of it?
Yes,
ma'am. Go ahead.
My brother sent me a mail.
Okay. Let me check if it is correct or not. Very good. So active will be he has sent the mail. Okay. So here we are using present perfect. Okay. The formula is subject plus has have plus V3 plus the object. Okay. And in passive, it will be object is being given importance, mail is being given importance. Yes. So helping verb will be has, have been. And what will be the formula of magical hand?
Mail was sent by whom?
Formula for magical hand. V3 plus by plus subject. This is common. Okay. The magical hand formula. And by this way, it will be changed to the mail has been sent. Now, is there a problem in adding a by with here? Like if I add by him, there is no problem. But in order to make your English a little bit polished, we avoid adding by after the words like someone, everyone, people, they, or common professions like doctor. And a profession like thieves, a thief is also being a professional. Okay, so we avoid that, right? And here the helping verb is going to be has been or have been. And this is present perfect helping verb. Okay, this has been done, this has been shown, this has been covered. Okay, now this has been saved for your reference later on. We will move to the next one now. The invitations were sent, easy, passive, and what will be the active one?
He has sent
invitation.
He sent.
You sent the invitation.
Invitation.
You sent.
Invitation. You sent the invitations. No. It is only the case when they, someone, everyone, you, people, such words are being given, then only you can hide them. Otherwise, if one person is there, you have to name him. Okay. So it just struck my mind. You know, yesterday I was watching this movie, Prince of Persia. How many of you have seen this movie? Prince of Persia, Sand
of China. I've seen half of it.
Okay.
I have seen it.
Okay, in case you get time, you just watch it, Prince of Persia. So there, a going to be prince gave a big gift to the prince of that particular sultanate he referred to as. So how would we converted into passive? Sorry? The going to be gave a present to be the prince of a sultanate.
A present has been sent.
Has been kyun aaya? I said gave.
The present was given by the prince.
Yes. Yes. So now here we cannot hide by, because we have particular names and they are specified people. So you cannot hide them, right? Now here, this is activity one, wherein you have to tell me that what passive voice can we use for all three of them individually. Let's talk about the first picture. Looking at the age groups. The crackers are burnt by the children. But anything else? Are burning. Chat box reply, please. One by one. This is not the way. One by one. Raise your hands. And in online class.
I mean passive or active?
Passive. Wait. Let me see how many of you are ready with it. Cheshta.
The crackers were
burned by them. Okay. Varanne?
Ma'am, the trees have been burned by the children.
Okay. Crackers were burning. You're using active voice.
Crackers
are plural.
Crackers were burned.
Okay. Passive. Yes.
They were asked to pose for a photograph by the photographer.
Okay, they were asked to pose. Photographer is obvious. Okay. Karthik?
Crackers were burned by kids.
Okay, Palak, crackers were burned by kids. Say the beautiful clothes were gifted to the children by their mothers. Okay, good. Siddhi, a different thought process. The crackers were being burnt by. Okay. Crackers were burnt by someone. Okay, Kian. Fine. Ethnic dresses have been worn by children. Okay. Diwali is celebrated by kids cheerfully. The rangoli was made by a cute girl. Okay. Rangoli is made by a girl. Fine, Tisha, Siddhi, good. And what about other pictures? Adhyan, Abhas?
Second.
Give importance to the thing which is inanimated. Yes.
The rangoli has been made by the girl.
Okay.
The graceful use of colors is being done by the girl.
Okay. Again, an active voice. Kind of headline, passive voice only.
The beautiful rangolis were made by the small children.
Okay.
Adhya has
great.
How express active
Repeat your sentence.
The God is trying her best to make
her. Now, what is the magical hands condition? That there will be a V3. And what you are giving us is a V1-ing, is trying to do that. So try that magical hand. Unless there is a magical hand, it's not going to be passive voice. Okay? The diyas were, Siddhi, chosen. Diyas were chosen by the girl for puja. Diyas were lighted by sweet girl. Okay, good. Decorated diyas are lighted by the girl. Okay, fine. Good one. And now we will indulge in another activity. This is short going to be something different, which I'm going to offer you this time.